I'm Nathan Hope, and I make the Godot Dialog Manager. In this video, I'm going to show you through a few example dialog balloons that I've put together to help you get started making your own dialog balloons. I've made a separate repository on GitHub that contains all of the examples I'm about to talk about. There's a link to that in the video description if you want to follow along in the actual project. Let's get started. By default, the Dialog Manager add-on comes with this example balloon. For basic dialog balloons, this is an easy enough place to get started. You can duplicate the folder and then move it somewhere outside of the add-on directory. Make sure to rename everything. Also make sure that any references point to your new balloon and not the example one. The two main things to watch out for here are the balloon script and any font references used. From here, you can make any customizations that you need to. This brings me to the first example, a pixel balloon for low resolution games. The actual behavior of this balloon is identical to the example balloon. All that's really changed is the background texture and the font. When shrinking fonts down this much, make sure you disable anti-aliasing. I've included the source aSprite file for this background in the repository. As you can see, there isn't that much to this one, so let's move on to the next example. A balloon featuring character portraits. This one is again based pretty heavily on the example balloon, but with a change to the layout to include this portrait slot. I've also set a minimum size for the margin node here. The margin node is what gets used for calculating the size of the balloon, so we want to make sure that it's always tall enough to show the portrait without being cut off. The portrait itself is an image that gets loaded based on the name of the character talking and set as the texture of a sprite. You could add some extra logic in here if you wanted to have multiple portraits per character based on the context of what they are saying. And that's all for that one. The third and last example I'll talk about is seemingly the most complicated one. This one is based on classic point-and-click adventure games. This one is not really based on the example balloon at all. It does, however, showcase some of the more advanced stuff that you can do. It includes running voice files when characters talk and then auto-advancing dialogue when the audio stream has finished playing. It also includes running talking animations for characters from within the balloon. Let me show you what I mean by all of this. Hi, I'm Nathan. This is Coco. Here are some response options. You picked the first one. I hope this example is helpful. This example also includes some basic localization with the voice files being auto-swapped by Godot when run under a different locale. Hallo, ich bin Nathan, und das ist Coco. Hier sind einige Optionen. Sie haben sich für die erste entschieden. Ich hoffe, das ist hilfreich. You'll have to excuse my pronunciation. I'm still only learning German and the Australian accent is difficult to suppress. To see how this works, we can first look at our actual dialog resource. As you can see, I'm using static translation keys. These keys are used to match audio files that get requested when the line starts. Godot takes care of remapping the English audio files with the German audio files via the project's localization settings. If we don't have any responses, we just wait for the audio stream to finish before advancing to the next dialog ID. Or if we have responses, then we show them and wait for a click. To stop and start the talking animations, I emit a signal via the global event bus. This signal is then picked up by the character node and used to play the relevant animation. In a real game, you would have more logic in here to play different kinds of talking animations based on the context of the scene, but this works for this example. And that's all there is to this one. So, as you can see, even a fairly complicated looking balloon doesn't actually have that much going on behind the scenes. Well, that's all the examples I have for now. I encourage you to check out the repository and have a poke around. If you have your own ideas for example balloons that you'd like to contribute, then open a pull request and I'll have a look. As always, if you have a question or a comment, then post it below or join my Discord. I'll see you there, or I'll see you here again soon. Bye.